Do you ever just get bored of a normal Minecraft world? Yeah, me too. That's why in today's video I attempt to survive 100 days hardcore in skyblock but with one block. That means none of the lush biomes that we're used to, all the mountains, plain biomes, the jungles, the deserts. I have to try and survive 100 days on one block. Let's find out if I can survive. Before we get into the video, I want to say thank you Finny for making me this fan art. It's really cool, I really appreciate it. But anyway, let's jump straight into the video. So here we are on the first day. It just gives me the instructions on how this actually works. I break a block and then it appears back, and that's pretty much it. Once I had enough dirt, I decided to expand the island and make a weird pattern shape because I wanted it to look cool. And I want to kind of make the island around nature and keep it grass as much as I possibly can. So yeah, this is pretty much the shape that I decided to go with. So we have the center block and then we have the dirt all around and everything like that. So once I had enough wood to make some slabs, I ended up making this little island bridge thing, and I'm pretty much replicating the dirt island but with slabs. So it was a night time there and I got some more dirt, so I decided to expand the opposite side on just this little dirt platform for no reason. Then I ran into a bit of a problem. Since we don't have torches, I kind of forgot that mobs can spawn. So a creeper, spider and a zombie spawned and I didn't know how to actually kill them without blowing myself up or dying. So to get rid of it, I just ended up mining the platform and killing them that way because I wasn't going to risk the creeper blowing up and destroying everything that I have. So on day 2 I got this mushroom cow, and I don't think I have to explain how important this is. This is just free food forever. So I quickly made a pen and I tried to get it in, and gladly I didn't push it off. This is just free food and I still use it later on in the series. It's just so important. Day 3, I'm expanding a different area that I plan on building my house. I wanted it to be a big enough size so I could have, you know, a big enough house. So I need to actually gather more wood, turn it into slabs. So here's a quick time lapse of me building. Day 4 a dog spawned and I had some bones and I really wanted this dog, but sadly this dog was trying to kill these foxes and then I accidentally let him out and he kind of just ran off the edge, so no dog yet. I also decided that I wanted to actually spruce up this area, so using some of the bone meal that I have, again I want this to be nature, so making all the grass and flowers around the mid area looks nice. Day 5 to 6, another dog spawns and I kept the bones on me just in case, and luckily there was no foxes so I got a dog. I want you guys to let me know what I should call this dog, if it's a male, female, I don't care, just give me names down below and I'll pick the best one. But of course, I had to make some purple dye, since purple is kind of my team colour. So now look at us, just so cute, I love dogs. So right now, we are getting an upgrade. As I said, the more and more you mine, the closer you get to an upgrade. Each upgrade gets harder to get to the next one, so this is just the first upgrade. Day 6 and 8, I'm expanding this area to make a farm, so I'm just marking out what I want the shape to be, and I have plenty of dirt, so time to actually get a farm so I can get some new food. So yeah, that is the farm area done. I don't know why I decided to make it that shape, probably fix it eventually. But right now I'm marking out the area that I want to build my house. Now this house, I've came up with this design like a year ago, but it's been a while since I've actually built it, and there's no real way to me show you guys me building this house. So the only way that I can actually show you guys is a time lapse. I know, I wish I could do something different, but yeah, there's a time lapse of me building this house. It's been a while since I built it, but this is one of my favorite houses, so here it is. So yeah, this is how it's looking. It's a different shape than my original design, but I still like how it looks. Since it was a different shape, I ended up having to do some stuff and it took a while, so I'm not even going to show trial and error of me trying to get this, because since it was a different shape, it was just so much harder to actually get the roof in and make it look nice. So this is a design that I ended up going with. We just need to change out some of the walls because they're kind of wrong, but that's pretty much it. So right now I'm doing the roof, and I always wanted to build it a prison room, but I've never actually bothered going out and getting some. So since we had it here, I decided to actually make the roof out of it, and I absolutely love it. This is my new favorite block. Absolutely love it. I'm not gonna lie, I think this design is better than my original build. It's a bit different, it's a bit weird, but I think it's a good weird. I just think it overall is a better version than my original design, and I absolutely love it. So right now I'm just gonna add the final details to the house, you know, some texturing, some buttons, some trapdoors, so here it is. So this is pretty much the house done with all the detailing and everything like that, and I actually love how this house comes out. A bit weird in the sky, but I still like it. So inside I'm just adding some details, making it a nice railing going up the stairs, you know, make it look more real, and I'm just going to add in the chest, the furnaces and stuff like that. Day 17 and 20 is a time lapse of me bringing all the junk from these other chests into the actual house. Now I'm not going to sit here and pretend that I'm going to actually put this in like proper chests and store it properly and all nice and neatly. No, it's just going to be random stuff. in random chests. I might have like one or two chests organized, but don't expect the rest of them to be organized. They're just gonna be messy. I don't care enough to take the all the junk and try put it into a nice sorting plan. No, not happening. Day 21 and 25, I ended up mining tons of jungle wood, and I'm pretty much marking out another area that I want to specifically have tons of trees, not a tree farm. I just want to have like a nice forest kind of area, because again, I want this skyblock to kind of feel more natural and like real, so I want to have plants everywhere and stuff like that, so that's exactly what I'm doing. Day 27, I tried taming this ocelot, but I don't remember Mojang changing this, but I'm pretty sure you can't tame ocelots anymore, you have to tame cats. So I was just unaware of that and I just gave this ocelot all of my fish. And sadly, since I was holding the fish, the cat fell off. I killed the cat. Even I killed the ocelot. I don't, what's the difference? This sign is just gonna stay here. I'm genuinely sad. I didn't mean to kill the cat. Day 30 and 36, I'm just mining away, gathering materials. Day 37, I decided to make a doghouse for the unnamed dog. So again, let me know what the name should be down below. But anyway, I decided to build a little doghouse because I felt bad just the dog, you know, sitting there. So here's a quick time lapse of me building it. Day 41 and 42 is just another time lapse of me mining and gathering materials. There's not much else I can do when I don't know what to build. So yeah, just enjoy this time lapse and the music. Thank you. Day 33, I'm doing exactly what I said I was going to do. Plant tons of trees. And since I'm getting jungle saplings, I really wanted to just make a huge jungle tree. And then I just kind of got through the saplings and made tons of other trees for no reason. I also then felt bad because I tamed the parrot and the parrot didn't have, you know, a place to kind of live. So I kind of made a parrot house because I felt bad that the dog had one and the parrot didn't. So, you know, I needed to make a place for him. Also, you can name the parrot down below. Name the parrot down below and the dog. I'm interested to see what you guys come up with. Day 46, these vexes were annoying. I don't fight vexes very often, but I just kind of ran away and left them despawn, let them just be them. I just was not about to die. So this is another upgrade. This is apparently like a mesa upgrade. Didn't think that was going to be a thing, but apparently it is, so I'm not complaining. Day 47 and 50, I end up having more jungle wood and I for no reason decide to make a huge platform, so here's a time lapse of me building. I also then decide to make another platform, like make another island for no reason, even though this is like the most useless thing I've done in this entire series, but why not? Again, I just want to make it look like lived in and homey. Then I also decide to actually join this up to the mushroom cow just so we can get around easier and there's less chance of me walking off. I also built this area here, so if we want to, we can expand. Day 53, I am just mining away and this fox spawned and picked up the diamond and I was going to kill it, but then I started running around and I just felt so bad, I didn't want to kill the fox, so I kind of just left it be and it just ran away and kept the diamond. I'm naming that fox, its name is Diamond, okay? That fox is now Diamond. Here is another time lapse of me mining. This villager kind of just came out of nowhere, got some more diamonds, some XP bottles, pretty good stuff all around. So I didn't show it, but these things called monster parties or something like that can spawn, and it's pretty much just a monster party, and I'm pretty sure you're supposed to get loot if you kill everything, but every time I just either run away and then they all fall off, and this was the only time that I've actually been able to kill them, but for some reason I still just didn't get any loot. I'm pretty sure you're supposed to get special loot once you kill them, but I'm yet to actually get this because I'm just unlucky apparently. So I hope you guys are enjoying the episode so far. I am actually having surprisingly a lot of fun editing this and playing this, but right now we're getting an upgrade, and this upgrade I did not expect to be so soon. This is a few upgrades in, but it's the nether upgrade. I genuinely didn't expect to get this at like phase 7, so I'm okay with it. Like, when I say I'm okay with it, I mean I'm okay with it. I literally got ancient debris. I'm not complaining. I'll take ancient debris all day long. But I need to make a diamond pickaxe because I'm 99% sure you cannot mine it with an iron pickaxe, and I'm not risking that. I'm not losing it. Not today. So day 57 and 65, I decided that I wanted to make a water elevator, and since we have access to nether blocks now, I'm able to do that. So this is just me testing stuff out and making sure that it would work. So would you believe it, it actually worked, but there's a problem. I didn't like the blocks that I used, so I had to tear it down and replace it with new ones. Boom, that's right, I changed it with jungle wood, stripped jungle wood. I think it looks way better with this than it did with the clay. I like this, it fits into the actual world way better. So on day 65 and 70, I end up making a huge mob farm. I haven't made a mob farm in years, so I had to follow a tutorial. So watch this huge time lapse of me making this mob farm. So this is it with all the decoration and just nice little touches to it. This is the mob farm, and I'm actually extremely happy with how it even just looks. And surprisingly, it's pretty good. Like, it actually works pretty well. Right now what you're looking at is at the back of it, where I can actually place some slabs and then I can actually kill them and, you know, get XP. But pretty much just mob drops, and it works surprisingly well. So this area, I didn't know what I was going to use this area for, but then after thinking about it, I thought this is actually like a great place to go AFK. So I decided to go AFK for a while, so this quick time lapse of going AFK just to see how well this mob farm actually works. So after that time lapse, these are all of the drops, and I'm not gonna lie, this is way more effective than I actually thought it was gonna be. This actually works so well that I might have to build this in a regular world. So I decided to go AFK again just to see what more loot I can get, but I'm not gonna show it. So day 80, after mining for a bit, I got a chest, and in the chest was a Wither Skeleton Skull. So I don't know, maybe you could be looking at eventually killing the Wither. That would be awful in a skyblock. But it's probably possible somehow. I got some ancient debris, and then I got some more ancient debris. I'll take it. I'm not complaining. This is so lucky. Day 81, I'm AFK again. And these are all the drops after a few days. I'm pretty much making it that it's going to be easier to sort, but this is a lot of stuff for this mob farm. This is actually surprisingly effective. I'm actually shocked. Day 88 and 91, I'm building out this platform that I did ages ago and didn't do anything with. So here's a quick time lapse of me building this. So yeah, this is pretty much the platform, and what I want this for is for an enchantment table, because I have nowhere to actually put it. I can't fit it in the house, so I decided to build this entire area just so we can enchant. I also decided that I wanted to decorate it, and this was going to be sort of like a, I don't know, like a, not like a mountain, but I'm gonna have stones and everything like that around, like stone walls and little stones and little bits of water and vegetation, all type of stuff in this type of area. So this is pretty much it. It's not completely finished, but this is pretty much how it's going to look. Have the nice sugar cane. I'm going to plant some bamboo. Once the grass grows, I can get more grass. I get some leaves eventually, and it just looks really, really nice. I also thought it was about time that I make some better armor. So I made some diamond armor, made some iron armor, and since I had enough ancient debris to make one netherite ingot, I decided to just skip over diamond completely and just go straight to netherite, because why not? I have no diamonds left, don't care. I am looking pretty good right now. Once I enchanted the armor, I got some pretty good enchantments, especially on the chest plate, but then I decided to actually just put it on this armor stand because I'm not about to fall off, I end up losing it, so we're just going to stay there until I actually need it. And as you can see, I'm actually using the mob farm for the first time as an actual XP. I don't actually like need the XP, I just want to see if it would actually work, and surprisingly, it does. You know, once I don't want to do this anymore, all I have to do is mine those 4 blocks and all the items just fall straight into the hopper, and it works really well. So we're at day 100, finally. I'm just mining casually away, trying to get to the next tier, and you know, I got this, I got more netherite, I got netherite scrap, I got blaze rods, this was insane, Jazz, thank you so much. But this was before the actual upgrade, so here we are. I am actually so sorry that I had to do you guys like that. That's right, I did end this on a to be continued. I'm gonna be completely honest with you guys, I did not expect to actually do it in a 100 day video, but I just randomly wanted to do one again and I did this. And I actually had a lot of fun doing this, more fun than I actually thought I would. To the point that I intentionally dragged it out because I wanted to do another 100 days in this. So if you guys can smash like on this video, show me some support, show me that you want to see me survive another 100 days, and I'll actually kill the Ender Dragon and I'll do all that stuff in the next video. But you guys have to show support, let me know that you want to see this. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, let me know in the comment section below of your thoughts, your things you didn't like, things I can improve on, let me know. I really appreciate it. But anyway, it's been Jamie. Peace.